Mark, thanks for your introduction. And good morning, everyone. I'm Weinan from Tsinghua University. It's my honor to present our work here. And the work is done with my collaborators from Tsinghua University and Stony Brook University. So what is VIPBoard? Briefly speaking, VIPBoard is the world's first ever smart keyboard designed for visually impaired people. So before we go on to the keyboard for visually impaired users, let's first talk about how to type sighted users. Everyone types on the smartphones every day. But have you ever noticed how you exactly type on the soft keyboards? Here is an example of input text on the keyboard. Well, from the video, you may notice that there exist errors during typing. Well, I didn't notice. In most cases, we just ignore the incorrect touches until we finish the whole word. After the space key is entered, the keyboard just autocorrects the wrong word into the correct one. So this is so-called word-level input and word-level autocorrection. How about visually impaired users? Can we just directly apply this smart technique for visually impaired users? Unfortunately, the answer is no. Because visually impaired users use the screen reader to use smartphones. As you may know, screen reader is a software that provides audio feedback of what the user is touching on the screen. So visually impaired users literally listen to the keyboard instead of looking at the keyboard while typing. So this little difference results in a completely different typing experience. Here is an example of how a visually impaired user enters text on a screen reader keyboard.
C, C, A, A, O, L, L, L,
call,
F, O, T, R, R,
4,
M, O, T, R, E, E,
more,
D, D, R, E, Y, T, T, A, I, L, L, S, S,
details.
Okay, as we can see, compared with what sighted users do, visually impaired users perform a character level input. So which means they must make sure its character is correctly entered before they continue on to the next one. So the reason of this feature may be the cost of correcting errors when the auto-correction fails is relatively high for visually impaired users. And the audio feedback provided by the screen reader is much more salient and noticeable than visual feedback, which prevents the users to ignore them. Therefore, there exists no correction methods for screen reader keyboards. Besides, visually impaired users produce much more errors at their first attempt of typing, which was indicated by those red circles. It's not surprising because of the lack of visual or tactile feedback for visually impaired users. So can we apply auto-correction to the character-level input method for visually impaired people? That's what VIPBoard do. Here is a simple overview of how people using VIPBoard.
Details.
So let's talk about some related work. As mentioned before, word-level auto-correction methods, well, including the first two papers in this session, have already been well studied and widely applied in our daily lives. Researchers have studied different algorithms or different contexts of word-level methods. Unfortunately, they are not suitable for visually impaired users, as mentioned. So there also exists some character-level auto-correction methods for sighted users. They usually change the layout or appearance of the keyboard each time a character is entered. However, these methods are even not welcomed by sighted users, because explicitly changing the keyboard may change the behavior of the users or come up with high cost by familiarizing with the new layout. They cannot apply to visually impaired users neither, because visually impaired users cannot directly perceive the change of the keyboard layout. Besides, there already exist some methods designed for visually impaired users. They usually focused on how to improve the ability of acquiring specific targets on the screen. For example, keep the number of targets low, put them at static and easy to reference positions, using gestures to avoid precise targeting, or use some hardware-based methods. These methods are either with low efficiency, requires much effort to learn, or is not convenient for daily use. To our knowledge, there exists no method which optimizes the widely used QWERTY layout keyboard or applies autocorrect feature to a keyboard for visually impaired users. VIPBoard fills the gap here. Next is the design details of VIPBoard. Let's first take a look at more details of a particular input. Let's say a user wants to input O in the word hello. The whole process can be divided into three phases.
K.
First, the user touches down on the keyboard to do an attempt for the target key. Usually because of the high inaccuracy of the user's behavior, the location is usually not correct. Therefore, the screen reader provides a wrong audio feedback. In this situation, the user needs a calibration operation to move the finger to the target key area. Note, there may not exist calibration phase if the user successfully finds the correct key when touching down on the screen. At last, the user simply lifts the finger to confirm this input. So among the three phases, the calibration phase is proved to be the most time-consuming process. Frequent calibration operations result in not only low efficiency, but also annoyance for visually impaired users. VIPBoard mainly focuses on how to reduce the calibration time during typing. To reduce the calibration time or totally remove this process, it requires that the first touch of the user is the target key of user's intention. This requires the first part of VIPBoard, a smart input prediction algorithm. The algorithm can figure out what the most probable intended character is according to the touch location and the characters already input by the user. Here I will skip the deduction part, and finally the probability is calculated by a touch model, which was presented by touch point distributions of its key. You may have seen this kind of figures a lot. And a language model, which is generated by the word frequencies. And for more details, please refer to our paper. So after prediction, we can provide the audio feedback of our predicted character. From the visually impaired user's point of view, he thinks he just touched on the correct key, which is O. In this way, the calibration time is removed as long as the prediction is correct. Well, the truth is that the prediction is indeed correct at most attempts, as we will show later. Thus, visually impaired users can input text with higher efficiency. But what if the prediction is not correct? What if the user's intention is not letter O? Well, from the user's point of view, if he finds the audio feedback is not what he wants, he would perform a calibration operation. This is how we are inspired to solve the problem in VIPBoard. We first move the predicted key O to a location under the user's touch location. And at the same time, the whole keyboard automatically scales to hold the relative layout of the whole QWERTY layer. So in this way, the user can easily lift the finger to input O.
O?
Or
P?
Input other keys by performing the same calibration operation, just as what they did on a traditional screen reader keyboard. We should keep in mind that the visualization is for demonstration only, and for visually impaired users with audio feedback only, what they feel like is they touched on the key O and then calibrated to key P. This is what they exactly do on screen reader keyboard. So this is what we call as a layout adaption strategy, which aims at providing a consistent interaction for visually impaired users and allow them to input any characters by the keyboard, no matter the prediction is right or wrong. Here is a brief summary of the design of VIPBoard. So far, by applying the input prediction algorithm at character level and a layout step adaption strategy, we designed a keyboard that has exactly the same interaction with a traditional screen reader keyboard, but with the ability of auto-correction and the potential of higher input efficiency. So to implement the keyboard, we need to analyze the touch behavior of visually impaired users. Therefore, we conducted a user study of 8 visually impaired participants. The participants were asked to input 100 words containing all the 26 letters, and we collect their input data, as some previous work did. So the collected touch model was fitted to 26 bivariate Gaussian distributions and shown in the figure. The arrow shows the offset from each key center to the corresponding distribution center, and the ellipses show one standard deviation of the touch distribution. As a contrast, here is a touch model of sighted users type on a small soft keyboard. Note that these ellipses already show 95% confidence of all touches, but it's still smaller than the ellipses left. So this touch model shows the relatively high input inaccuracy of visually impaired users, which highlights the importance of an auto-correction feature. We then used the model collected in this study to implement a prototype of VIPBoard, which supports both English and Chinese pinyin input. We used the same setup to evaluate the performance of VIPBoard. We recruited 14 visually impaired users to input 20 phrases for four sessions on a VIP board and a traditional screen reader keyboard in both English and Chinese languages. So here's a simple comparison of two keyboards entering the same sentence, and the video is muted. Then I will quickly go through some detailed results of the evaluation. As for text entry speed, VIPBoard is about 12.6% higher than the screen reader keyboard. It's significantly higher. And the overall corrected or uncorrected error rate are all very slow, very low, with no significant difference found between the two keyboards. An important metric I want to introduce here is miss rate, which is calculated by the ratio of touches that misses the target at touchdown phase. Or in other words, the ratio of touches that need calibration. So under this definition, a lower miss rate indicates higher input accuracy of the user. And lower miss rate indicates a more smooth text entry experience. So results show that the miss rate of VIP board is 63% lower than the screen reader keyboard. And the miss rate of almost every key, as shown in the figure, is lower than the screen reader keyboard. The subjective rankings of users of VIP board also outperformed the screen reader keyboard significantly among all the aspects. As for the qualitative feedback, the most important point is that users agree VIP board is easy to learn and use. As we designed the consistent interaction with screen reader keyboard, there is no learning cost for visually impaired users. When using two different keyboards, if we do not tell them which keyboard they are using, they nearly can feel the difference between the two keyboards, except for the high accuracy of VIP board. What's more interesting is that they mistakenly thought the difference of touch accuracy as their varying touch ability instead of the auto-correction feature from the keyboard. And we are happy about that because VIP board literally became transparent to the users, which indicates a very successful interaction design. Other results include their performance of using gestures or their high expectations of VIP board. So finally, a quick summary of VIP board. VIP board is a smart keyboard designed for visually impaired people, which applies a character level auto-correction algorithm and a layout adaption strategy. Compared with traditional screen reader keyboards, VIP board could improve text entry speed and reduce touch error rate. There exists no learning cost for visually impaired users, and as widely welcomed by visually impaired users, we hope VIP board can actually bring the smartness to screen reader keyboards and benefit them in the future. That's all. Thank you. I have brought a live demo here. If you are interested, you can contact me to experience our video, our demo of VIP board.
Very excellent work. I really enjoyed that. Jinji,
thank you.
Same from Google. Just curious about for the standard keyboard, what do you think is the mental process for them to correct from an incorrect character? Because as a sighted user, if I press K and the character is I, I wouldn't know the I is above the K. Do you think they just give a try in that distributed area?
I think what you mean is that the layout of the keyboard actually changes during their typing. So are you wondering if the users can perceive the change of the keyboard layout?
That was not my question.
My question was, how well do people know the keyboard?
How well, okay.
The problem of them not knowing how to adjust?
Yeah, the users are required to be familiar with the QWERTY layout of the keyboard. Actually, visually impaired users are all very familiar with the keyboard because they need to touch on the key layout to find the correct key. So, and our method does not require the exact position of each key. If they touch just near the target key, we can use our prediction algorithm to predict the correct one for them. So, their input accuracy seems to be improved by using VIP board. Thank you.
Do you want to ask?
Hi, this is Yu Junko from Stony Brook University. A great talk. Just a quick question. So since that you assume that the user has a rough mental map of the key map, like before they conduct the experiment, so I'm wondering that you have the adjustment for the based on the prefix neighbor key. So what if like there's like large offset, like not just like key around the target key, like maybe two keys away. So how do you deal with that situation?
Thank you. If the target, there's some details in our paper, if you can refer. There are some detailed designs. Like if the predicted key is too far away from the from the key they touched, the prediction process will fail. And we will just read out what the key they exactly touched. Instead of the predicted one. So this is for providing consistent perception of their mental model of the keyboard layout. Okay, yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much again, and well done again.